edition here of All in the Reflexes. So we're mixing up things a little bit tonight. This is really exciting. And so I'm glad that you're joining us. If you're on Facebook, we're glad that you're watching. We got a feed streaming here on Facebook and on YouTube. Anyway, I'm here tonight with a very special guest. His name is Camron Johnson, and he's a graduate of ICC. He graduated Illinois Central College after studying art design here, and he went on to do some really cool things. We're going to learn all about that. You know, he ended up getting a bachelor's degree in studio art design or drawing, at Illinois State University, which is really cool. But you know, we made contact actually through Illinois Central College, and we started talking about art projects, particularly what it would be like to maybe turn Rabbit in Red into a graphic novel, or see what other possibilities exist, as this is the first book in a horror trilogy. Camron read it, gave me some feedback, and actually sketched a design reimagining the cover. And so what we're going to do tonight that I'm really excited about is tonight we're going to watch him do the cover or redesign an image that we're going to turn into promotional art and posters live right in front of us. So again, those of you just joining, my name is Joe Chianakas. This is All in the Reflexes. It's a live web talk show hosted out of Illinois Central College. We talk about cool people and the things they've done here at ICC. My website is FrightFest4D.com if you want to learn more about the book or how to be on the show. But I'm going to turn it over here to Camron. We're going to turn the cameras so that you can see his art. And I'm going to use our Facebook feed here. So that'll be just perfect, I think.
Hello, world.
So, Camron, welcome, and thank you for joining me here tonight. Those of you watching on Facebook, if you want, what I'll do is I'll kind of I'll play with the camera a little bit. But if you are on my Facebook page, there's also a YouTube link. What's really cool about the program we're using on YouTube is you can see both us talk and his art at the same time. If you're watching Facebook, I'm just going to have to kind of play with the camera a little bit, but either way works. So Camron, tell us a little, you know, before we get started with drawing, tell us a little bit about yourself and how you got into what interested you in wanting to major in art, make a career out of it, those types of things.
Absolutely. I started reading some scary books when I was a little kid. I started reading Scary Stories to Tell in the Dark, and that had some artwork with it. And an artist, Stephen Gammel, he just created some wild imagery that pretty much stuck with me till I was, you know, early, you know, eighth grade or ninth grade, and just started getting into a little more fantasy, started watching a lot of movies, and but throughout all this time, I was always sketching, and then as soon as I got in my sophomore year of high school, I started taking some art classes and started taking them seriously, and then started realizing that, you know, if this is what I'm enjoying, you know, every day, then this is what I really need to go into, so, you know, put the throttle down and started drawing all day, just every day. It's all I did. So really looking forward to starting on this piece for you and seeing what we can come up with.
Absolutely. I'm glad you're here. So I like to play with the audience who's watching us either on YouTube or Facebook, guys. And what I'd love to say is if you will make a comment tonight, we're going to turn this into a poster. I'm going to, you know, you're going to love it. I've seen the draft. I've seen the sketch. You're absolutely going to love it. But if you make a comment on our feed tonight, and the question I'm going to throw out there is, what's your favorite scary movie? I'm going to keep it pretty simple. So comment what your favorite scary movie is, your favorite horror movie or Halloween-themed movie in honor of Rabbit in Red. And we're going to select a few winners once we get posters made. I tell you, it's going to be really, really sweet. So just comment. We'll pick some winners up down the road. So
let's do this.
Yeah, let's do it.
So I lately I've just been working with ink. I kind of skipped the whole entire sketch process.
Okay.
Ink, it's great. The permanence kind of gets your adrenaline going.
Yeah.
Because you're forced to kind of work with it. So I'm going to get started here. I know what I'm designing. I don't really want to give it away early, but let's just see what we can do.
And so I'll talk to you a little bit and share some things as we go with, you know.
So is this going here?
Yes, so great. We can see you perfectly. So if you're on YouTube, again, those of you watching live on Facebook, hi. All right, I'm going to turn this around. So here's the program that we've got that we use for YouTube, so you can kind of see that. So we have a camera set up where we can chat, but you also can see we got a camera focused in on the artwork. And this, again, is Camron Johnson. I put his website up there, CamronJohnson.com, if you want to check out his artwork or, you know, hire him for a project down the road. But anyway, that YouTube link was shared on my Facebook page and his. So if you, it's up to you which one you want to watch live. Obviously, the Facebook one is cool, and we're just going to kind of turn it around and get to see him this way too. But I'll hold it up every now and then so you can actually see some of the different work that he's doing. So anyway, so you read Rabbit and Red. Out of the, you like a lot of different horror references in there. What's tell me about some of your favorite scary stories or books or anything like that that you've
I am a big fan of a whole lot of different horror genres. Really love sci-fi. Really, really enjoy just anything with a lot of anything without too much CGI. I mean, a little bit's okay when it comes to sci-fi. It's necessary, but I really appreciate things that are handmade.
Sure.
You know, those movie monsters that really really freak you out that aren't CGI. I think that's just an incredible feat to be able to make something out of the imagination.
I think about that a lot, actually, because like you watch an older, even older 80s horror film, sometimes it just seems more authentic or something than all the CGI that you see today, for sure.
Absolutely.
So I'm going to move the Facebook feed a little bit so we can see exactly what it is you're doing. So tell us a little bit about what you're doing here.
Yeah, I'm just doing a basic ink run over the outline of what I am wanting to draw here. I'm going to go back through with pen and ink and then other colors, too, to give this a wash. But right now, just sketching out this this drawing, but in ink. It's kind of a backwards process, but I've started to find out that I'm able to do it a whole lot better than I thought.
Cool. So again, we are live, and we've got a handful of viewers on Facebook and YouTube, so I really appreciate you guys jumping in to join us. Again, my name is Joe Chianakas. All in the Reflexes is a web show that I kind of came up with the idea for this late last fall, early winter, and the idea was to say, let's meet some cool people out there in our community. I want to start with those focused here who have a connection at Illinois Central College, obviously, because this is my home. I'm a professor here. That's my main job. I teach in the communication program, and it's kind of funny. One of my colleagues is the one who actually recommended Camron to me and said, you got to check out his work. And she gave me, so let's plug this a little bit here for everybody, an art project you did here. This is called The Neighbor, Thy Neighbor.
Yeah.
So this is an original comic book that you did?
I did, yeah, absolutely. It was Anita Chillo. She's a great professor here at ICC. So if you're thinking about coming out here and taking some classes, she's a wonderful, wonderful professor. So she taught me a lot in the figure drawing field and decided to make a comic book. After, of course, I, you know, approved it and got, you know, made sure I showed the training that I went through and was able to do it in the semester just here in class. And so, you know, ICC, it was great. It was a great experience, and I learned a lot and provided a great foundation to what I'm trying to do.
Fantastic. So, again, what we're trying to say is if you want to post a comment, let us know you're watching either on YouTube. If you're on YouTube, you got to log into YouTube. That's what I've been told. And if you're on Facebook, you can just comment anytime. But we want to know what your scary movie is. We're going to talk about it. Camron is drawing for us live a reimagining of Rabbit in Red. When he read it, he wrote me and said, you know, that, and I'm glad. I'm glad you actually followed back up and said, hey, I enjoyed the story. Because, you know, I've worked with people who, you know, not everyone's going to like everything. Of course, everyone's got their own different interests. But he, our original cover here, and I love my original cover, don't get me wrong, but we have a rabbit with hiding an axe. And so this is kind of like a Polaroid. If you imagine, it's got a Polaroid theme, but more it was trying to look like an app. In the book, you meet these teenage characters who love horror, and what they want to do is, you know, make it their lives. So they find this game, basically, it's an app game. It starts, you know, on your iPhone or your iPad, and it's like, it's a trivia game, and this would be like the image that you would see perhaps on that game. And if they do so well and they get so many questions right, then they're invited to Rabbit and Red Studios. Rabbit and Red is, in the story, is the name of a Hollywood studio that is hosted by Jay Bell, or JB. He's our big old, oh, I don't know, I don't want to call him a villain, but he's your crazy eccentric guy.
He
might be a villain.
He's the madman.
Yeah.
He's got some wild ideas.
One of my favorite reviews is from a fellow author on an Amazon page, and she talked about who her favorite characters were, and her favorite was Rose. Actually, she said Rose was shy, kind of like herself, but her least favorite was JB because he's a creep. And there's some issues there of maybe cyber-stalking and learning about things that are going on in their lives.
Just a little bit.
So Cameron's going to take this art or this original idea that we had and from reading the story and turn it into his own unique idea to kind of make it darker, I think, to make it to really illustrate a couple of unique components of the story. So I'm really excited to see what's happening there. So let's take a look at what you're doing.
Yeah, right now, I don't know if you're able to see it quite yet, honestly. I've done an okay job at making this look, you know, not so easily tangible. I don't really know how to describe this yet, but we'll keep going and see what comes out.
Really cool. So again, thanks for joining us, guys. If you make a comment about what your favorite scary movie is on our Facebook page or our YouTube page, we're gonna make some really neat rabbit and red posters. I'm gonna send those out to people if you'd love to have one. I think it's gonna be really sweet. So again, I've seen the sketch of it. So tell us about some of the favorite pieces that you've done before. What's your favorite personal work?
Yeah, personal work, absolutely. I have a few books in the works right now. Other than Thy Neighbor, that's a series of three that I'm yet to work on the other two. But I have a children's book in the work. It's a story that kind of can help somebody through just a difficult time in their life. And regardless, you know, if you're a young kid getting bullied or if you're a full-grown adult trying to get through something in your life, the book, it's a motivational tale. And so what I'm trying to do with it is see what happens in the publishing field. Hopefully one day someone can pick that up. But until then, I have another book going. It's Poems for Turtles, The Slow and the Ugly. It's about a 40-page book with full art and poems to go along with them.
So are you writing the poetry too?
Yeah, absolutely. I do a little bit of writing, not as much as I do drawing, but it's a hobby of mine that I'm trying to take on to a different level here.
That's awesome.
Yeah, it's an interesting field to get into. You know, you really have to be ready to put yourself out there a little bit.
Publishing's a hard industry because you put, I can't tell you how many hours that went into Rabbit and Red. I know you put in lots of hours. I mean, it's hours upon hours upon hours, and you have a product that it's gone through lots of stages and evolutions and development, and then you finally get it out there to the world, and it's probably the simultaneous most scary and most exciting thing out there.
Absolutely.
So I did my first book club last night, which was really fun. I've got a couple of book clubs I'm doing, so and it's really neat, but it was a Peoria Public Library book club for adults who enjoy reading young adult themed stories. It was an interesting challenge because most of them weren't really fans of horror, but they were trying to broaden their horizon out there. So it's really neat to talk about, I'm talking about people who've never seen hardly any scary movies. So it's very interesting to come across that. So let's see what scary movies
have
you guys got out there so far? What have we got comments? Kaylee, you want to come join us? So I'll bring you on camera over here. That way we have a couple of people to chat with. So one of the things I'm really excited for as we do this show is let's bring out a chair. Is that I have an assistant. Her name is Kaylee.
Hi.
I'm going to get you a chair over here.
Thank you.
And we'll see how it matches up on camera in a moment. Perfect on YouTube, and then for those of you watching on Facebook, we'll turn over here. Here's Kaylee.
Hi.
So Kaylee is an Illinois Central College student. Kaylee, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Well, I'm technically a freshman here at ICC. I love it. I love marketing, and I like kind of social media, so that's what I'm here for, is to really focus on the social media part of things. I just started off working for as your assistant officially yesterday.
Yep.
It was the official first day, so it's exciting.
So I've been fortunate. I've had, several students out there who have helped on official or unofficial capacities. And the Kaylee is our first official college credit intern. So she's learning all sorts of behind-the-scenes stuff, and she's going to be working with me and a few of our other writers over at Distinguished Press. So she's actually working with multiple authors, and that just started yesterday, and we're going to see what we can do. So that's really exciting. So let's take a look at what are some of the comments so far for favorite scary movie.
Hey, what do they got out there?
Ruben said that Chucky was his favorite scary movie.
Okay.
Tyler Brown said that Scream was his.
All right, hold on. Let's talk to Ruben. Ruben, are you still with us?
I'm sure
you Chucky? Chucky's scary if you're like six, I think. I don't know if it's scary now. He's a doll, right? I don't know. I've got to give him a hard time because we know Ruben. And I know Ruben's not the biggest fan of scary movies, so we'll give him a hard time. Tyler, Scream.
Brandy said Nightmare on Elm Street. I spelled Nightmare wrong. I just saw that. Because she loves Johnny Depp.
Well, and knowing what I know about Brandy, that's probably the only reason she would like a Nightmare on Elm Street. I mean, she likes Freddy. So that's a good question. You know, like between the big slashers out there, who's your favorite slasher? How about you guys hearing her?
Yeah.
You got a favorite slasher?
Scream's great, Tyler. That's a great movie. The twist in the end when I first saw it, that was great. It was a great shot. Great ending to a slasher flick. Psycho is always a great and original.
So I'm moving the camera over here. If you're watching on YouTube, this is going to be fantastic. Because he's like, I've got the selfie stick up in the air, and I'm moving
nice.
The phone around, and it's fantastic. But whatever, we're trying to show multiple viewers here. It's the age of social media and technology. But we've got, so you can kind of see, I'm trying to, oh, yeah, that's really coming together. Now you can see, I mean, I'm getting, can I say anything yet? Or what do you want to say about what
you're
drawing?
Yeah, you should probably find out here. This is going to be a skull in a virtual reality helmet here.
So you see the beginning of a skull, and up here, then rabbit ears?
That's right. That's right. And a little bit of the rabbit in here. The story, the novel that Joe wrote is heavily included with virtual reality. And it's a pretty interesting subject. And so I thought I'd twist it up a little bit and include some of the virtual reality elements to the drawing here.
Sure. So in the story, for those of you who haven't read Rabbit in Red, and by the way, let me give a few shout-outs. So again, we're a live show, so every now and then I feel like I got to do that whole radio thing. If you're just joining us, my name is Joe Chianakas. You're watching All in the Reflexes. This is a live web talk show. We stream on Facebook and YouTube. This is my assistant, Kaylee. She's making sure that I don't have any more technological hiccups, right, Logan, Kyle,
yes.
And James, for those of you who went 30 minutes with me while we had really bad sound. Sorry. I still feel absolutely terrible about that. And this is artist Camron Johnson. He's a graduate of ICC and Illinois State University as well. And he is an artist and a writer and has a vision, you know, and my thing, I just absolutely love working with other people who have, you know, that sort of vision and enthusiasm for things. So I feel like you never know. You do one video, you have one really great piece of art that gets out there, and suddenly it opens up a thousand more doors for you. You just never know.
That's the wild thing about it, you know, is it takes just a moment for something to hit off. And it's the risk you got to take, but you got to make sure you're having fun doing it.
So we're
you're not enjoying it, you know.
And that's the thing. It's like I talked about hours and hours and, you know, over a year's worth of time of preparation goes, you know, went into the novel. And if you don't enjoy it, it's not worth it.
You're not gonna hold that passion. You're not gonna want to drive it any further.
So we're taking a look. And again, if you're on the YouTube link, which a handful of you are, that's really cool. You can get a nice close up of what he's doing. And so we got a skull with the beginning of a virtual reality headset. And in this story, in Rabbit in Red, one of the things I like to use is how can we use virtual reality to scare people a little bit more or test people at the same time. So we have these horror fans who initially enter Rabbit in Red Studios in Hollywood, California, and they're entered into a competition that's designed to be the, you know, we're promoted to be the scariest thing ever, right? Or the most exciting thing ever at the same time. But they really have to show their horror knowledge. So they get to enter these virtual reality chambers and do a bunch of things with famous horror movie scenes. So it's not simply reenacting, although there is a scene there where they do reenact, but they actually start to get to manipulate the scenes. But we use a technology, and I don't even think I used this wording in the first book, which is why this is so cool. But the technology that I call it in book two, because again, this is the first book of the trilogy, is the rabbit's eye. And the rabbit's eye is a virtual enhancement, sort of like what you would imagine a 4D, a virtual reality game. What's the what's the big game that people are, that Facebook has, it's on pre-order right now.
For PlayStation. Is it the,
Well, there's the, if you stop talking,
what's it called?
We die, there's that one.
Oh, help me out, guys. What's the name of that? Oh, gosh. It's like the Omni... I don't know.
I've seen it. It's the over the head.
There's the one that
it's
we
coming.
Were the goggles,
yeah.
And it's like it
that's
was
it.
Morpheus. Is it Morpheus? Project Morpheus? That's what it was called before.
I didn't know the bomb one.
Well, anyway, I know it's available for pre-order. Mark Zuckerberg did a thing on Facebook. It's like $500. Yeah, we'll Google it. So it's the big virtual reality set. And I was really influenced by a book called Ready Player One. I read that a bunch of times, and so there's certainly some Ready Player One influence in here too. But yeah, this is going to be really sweet. So it cracks me up because a lot of times people will see the cover of the book and they're like, "Is there a rabbit monster?" No.
No.
The rabbit in red is the name of a Hollywood studio, but there certainly is an image of a rabbit, and it's much more powerful in the second because, I can't give that away, but book two is done. I mean, I want to publish it tomorrow. I have no idea because it's dark, it's gritty, we got a lot of different things going on, and we go in a new direction, and that's the thing is that I'm a fan of, like it or hate them, I'm a fan of stories that give you a few different perspectives, not just the same story over and over again. So book two, we're going a pretty different angle with horror. And the first book, I would say, is like your celebration. The second book is your death. So let's talk. We got Oculus Rift. Tyler's got it.
There you go.
I just pulled it up. And
I've said it 100 times.
It looks crazy.
I can't
really
remember.
Does. It looks absolutely wild. And,
yeah.
That's the future right there. So this is, you know, it's a good, solid topic that even discuss in general is virtual reality and where that's headed.
Yeah.
Because that's the future right there.
Because there's a game where all you have to do is wear a headset and you defuse a bomb. Actually, there's two people. So one person who doesn't see the room has the manual and they have to explain to the other person who has the goggles on and can see the bomb how to defuse it.
Okay.
So you're actually, there's one person actually looking at the bomb and there's like a bunch of little modules they have to like figure out. And the other person has the thing and can see it.
Well, yeah, and if you think about it, not just for gaming purposes, but for medical purposes and other training, there's
absolutely
a lot of potential stuff out there. So let's take a look. So yeah, I love the Scream movies. Tyler's a big fan of the Scream. So there's a virtual reality section where we play with the Scream movies and Rabbit in Red, and I love that.
Yeah.
And it changes things. That's the whole idea, is for the story to change some of our favorite movies a little bit too. Because I don't know, I without giving it away for those who haven't read it, but I love the concept or the idea, like when you're watching, even if you've seen a movie 100 times, and I've seen Scream 100 times, and you know he's going to die, but you still, don't you just kind of root for them a little bit and say,
every time,
come on, you can get out that door, you can do it. I know that the tape, the film isn't going to change, but I'm still hoping that something happens where they save themselves. And so that's one of the ideas that influenced one of the particular virtual reality games that our characters are going to do in Rabbit in Red. Can they perhaps make those changes based upon the knowledge they have of the film? So,
do you want me to be completely honest?
Yeah, what's that?
I've never seen The Scream.
Oh,
no.
My gosh.
I believe Drew Barrymore is in it, though.
Yeah. You should watch it if you like scary movies.
Okay, so here's the thing about Scream, right, guys? All right. So the thing about Scream... If you haven't seen Scream, here's the thing. So I saw this in like 1997, maybe.
Or 1997.
I don't even want to talk to you anymore. All right, it's crazy. All right, but Scream. So Drew Barrymore was a child. Let's give you some Scream history for fun while Cameron's drawing. All right, and this is all off the top of my head, but you know I hope I better know something if I you're a horror writer, right? So here's the thing. 1997 or so, Scream comes out, and first of all, I remember seeing it, and the theater still exists. Which I saw at a Landmark Theater. In Peoria. And Landmark in the 90s might have been even sketchier. Let's just say that. I can remember a packed theater, people smoking, passing around a cigarette, passing around a flask of liquor. It was a fantastic time, all right? Now, I was like 16 and not participating in any of that, of course. So, of course not. But it was a great time. So Drew Barrymore was labeled as the star of Scream. Now, if you're a fan of like E.T., What other, Firestarter, Stephen King story. Drew Barrymore started off as a child star, right? And then she went through like a lot of Hollywood stars. She went through a really hard time, and I don't know, crash and burn, and drug addicts. I don't know, drugs, and who knows what all else. But they labeled Scream as like one of her comebacks to cinema. And she was in the previews, and I know we were all excited. I mean, Drew Barrymore was like, she was the chick that you were into when you were a teenager in the 90s, right? She was hot, and you loved her, and she was awesome, right? And so everybody, I remember going to the great big group, and everyone's really excited to see Drew. There's a cigar. Well, there were cigarettes too. All right, but I remember everybody seeing. And if you're watching on YouTube, I'm responding to random Facebook comments. Just sometimes I feel like, why did he just say that? Anyway, we're really excited for Drew Barrymore. And here's a spoiler alert. Are you ready? In like 5 minutes, she gets killed.
She's gone.
And I'm like heartbroken immediately. It is the best, definitely one of the best openings to any horror movie out there.
Yeah.
It's the classic. She gets a prank call. They ask her what her favorite scary movie is. They even give her a little trivia. And then she gets it. She's done. And like, but she was marketed as the star of the show. How do you do that? So anyway, if you've read Rabbit in Red, you'll understand why that particular, you'll certainly understand that scene, my upset at Drew Barrymore's death has stuck with me for like 20 years, because in this book, we're going to save her. I'm just going to spoil it. We're going to save her, and she's going to be okay.
Yeah.
And but we do that with a couple of films. All right. So anyway.
She dies in the movie.
It's still heartbreaking to me. So anyway, for those of you, again, we're getting people who are just jumping on both the YouTube channel and the Facebook live feed, which is really cool. So allow me to do a couple introductions a few times. Again, I'm Joe Chianakas. I'm the author of a book called Rabbit in Red, which is a horror book. That's why we're talking about things like this today. This is my assistant, Kaylee. She's a student here at Illinois Central College. And this is our special guest of the night, Camron Johnson. This is he is a book artist and illustrator, and he is here to do a live drawing for Rabbit in Red. And again, if you're, it's really starting to come together.
Yeah, it's all about taking, you know, dropping the ink and pulling it off to get those layers down. So that's kind of what I'm doing right now. Just putting drops of ink where I'm seeing some shadows and pulling it back off. And then eventually here we're going to start working with some of the ink pens that I brought along with me, my little tools of destruction. And we'll see what comes out here. But so far, yeah, it's looking okay.
So were you always an artist?
Oh,
like, did you always draw things as a kid, or?
I think everybody's got a little bit of something in them when it comes to the arts.
Yeah.
You know, everybody has to express themselves a little bit, but this is just what I chose to do. It's easy. You can do it anywhere you want. You can sit down and just sketch and doodle and think about things, or, you know, you can sit down like this, tape off the corners, and make a work of art, and it's a blast. It's a great time.
And you can't, for those of you, I just had a point that I'm a big fan of the shirt. It's got a Gizmo shirt on.
Here's my favorite movie right here.
Yeah, Gremlins, absolutely.
It's
and
a classic.
There's some Gremlins references in Rabbit in Red.
It's a classic Christmas.
It's my favorite Christmas horror film.
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. I love it.
I feel like I've missed out on a lot of these references because I've seen maybe 5 horror movies in total.
Well, and my hope is that maybe the book will, you know, I don't know, there's 100 reasons why you write something or do something, but one of mine is, isn't it, okay, so think of it this way. You have a favorite movie or something, right? Everybody's got a favorite something, and you come across a person who's never watched it. Don't you kind of flip out and say, you absolutely have to watch blank. I can't believe you haven't seen this. How can we be having this conversation? Kaylee hasn't seen the Scream movies.
Yeah.
Next time I need a much more thorough vetting process before having someone come help me out. Like, you know, their own little horror contest. That would be kind of fun, don't you think? But yeah, so you come across, like, you have to see Scream. Scream is fantastic. And that's part of what I hope people got out of the book. And I'd mentioned earlier that I did my first book club last night. And I think probably the coolest thing out of that, one of the coolest things I got out of it is a lady had told me that after reading Rabbit in Red, she went and read Stephen King's Misery and Stephen King's It. And so that was one of the cool things for me. I was like, because those are stories that I absolutely love, and it inspired her to go out and to read these other books. Not that Stephen King needs any, you know, more readers, but no, it's wonderful. Everybody should read that type of stuff. But so those are one of the things that makes me happy too. So let's take a look. We've got some other Tyler. Oh, okay, never mind. I'm just reading the comments here. I've never seen Scream. I know, I'm disappointed too. Okay, so give us some other. We got Jason. Hi, Jason. Jason, Texas Chainsaw. Big fan of Texas Chainsaw. This also reminds me, I've got to give a shout out. So we're doing a couple of contests online for the book too. So if you've been following my page at all, then you've seen me post about these contests on a horror page called Fits of Horror, F-I-T-Z. That's how you spell Fits. Awesome dude. His name, Brian is his name, Brian Fitzgerald. He has been, he got a copy of Rabbit in Red last year sometime, actually. And we've been talking about, you know, he's always constantly posting about horror films and things. And it's awesome because, you know, share similar interests. Anyway, his page has almost 30,000 followers. And he is doing a contest for the book right now. So we made a little video. It's on the Fits of Horror page. If you share, like, or comment on that, you're automatically entered to win the video. And I'm also doing a Goodreads contest. If you happen to have a Goodreads account, get on there, add the book, enter that. That would be awesome, too. But the reason I thought of Fits of Horror is Jason's favorite, Texas Chainsaw. I know that Fits, I think, and correct me if I'm wrong, if you happen to be catch this later, but Fitz's favorite is Leatherface, I think. His favorite, or either Leatherface is his favorite, or his favorite movie is also Texas Chainsaw out of all the horror films. So, have you guys seen Texas Chainsaw?
I have. I've seen the old one, the new one. I think there's a couple new ones, aren't there? There's a few remakes.
One's really bad, but I feel like there was one where they try to, like, it was the 3D
it's like
one.
It was like a just 3D prequel, wasn't it?
Of course there's a 3D
like a prequel.
One. It was a prequel.
Yeah.
It was awful. I was really sad.
Once you go down that route, you know, things are starting to...
But I like the original and the remake, you know, when they start out, they're listening to Sweet Home Alabama, they get pulled over, they throw the illegal substances out the window or whatever, and then it all starts from there. That's a pretty good, I like that one a lot too. So Texas Chainsaw is awesome. Definitely a big fan of that. Who else we got on Facebook here?
Zach said The Ring was his favorite horror movie, and Chad's in The Omen, which I am not seeing.
Yep, The Omen.
I've also never seen Texas Chainsaw. I'm really bad.
Oh, man.
I
gotta do a horror education.
Yeah, no. Watch some movies, not drawing pictures.
Right, so anyway, if you're watching on Facebook, I'm coming back over the art for a little bit while we chat, so you can check that out. Again, this is a reimagining of Rabbit in Red, kind of a Rabbit in Red symbol, and I think that this could definitely be the Rabbit in Red symbol. I think this would be absolutely fantastic. No doubt about it. Yeah, so adjust me. Thank you.
There he
goes
a little bit.
Awesome. That is awesome. And it looks beautiful. Again, if you're watching on YouTube, we've got a great, great shot of it. It's really cool. So I'm doing these bi-weekly shows, second and fourth Wednesday of the month, all in the Reflexes. It's just meant to be a live web talk show. We've got a lot of cool guests lined up. Next week, I'm talking with a former student who's still an ICC student, but a former student of mine named Kayla Fast. And we're going to talk a little bit. She's got quite an interest in horror films, too. So we got a couple of cool games planned for that particular night. But we had to make a special edition. So this is my first All in the Reflexes special episode, special edition. You know, kind of like going live or on the scene or whatever. And so I had to see this. And this was Camron had sketched this out a while ago. And then, we thought, how cool would it be to actually do this live and get to talk to him a little bit about the process and things like that. So The Omen had a remake. So Chad, by the way, shout out to Chad Ballard. Chad has a book that you guys should check out as well. His book is called Sentinel. And he is a fantasy writer as well as a former student of mine. And his book Sentinel is published through Realm Walker Publishing. And I believe it's going to be a trilogy or more, too, but the first one is out, so you guys should definitely check that one out, too. Chad, thanks for watching. For all of you guys, first of all, thank you very, very, very much for joining us live. I know you got things to do, and there's other shows to watch, whether you're watching for 5 minutes or you're sticking around for the whole time, you're absolutely awesome. You know, I think being successful in this world, whether you're an artist, an author, or anything in that realm, requires a huge amount of support. I know you guys, for me, I'm constantly sharing stuff and be like, hey, check out this contest or check out this review or please review the book. Good reviews, you guys are so helpful, right? Just any sort of nice comments that you can throw on there. And you're supportive and you do it and you put up with me I certainly appreciate it. So thanks for sticking with us no matter what. So The Omen had a remake that came out on, this was the only really cool thing I liked about The Omen remake. It came out on 6606. That's sweet. So they had that. Yeah, isn't that awesome? So there's my little Omen trivia for you. When did the remake for The Omen come out? 6606.
That's actually easy to remember, though.
Yeah, it is pretty easy. So you can use that trivia wise. So let's take a look again. Oh,
close up.
So we're live, by the way. So appreciate your comments. And what for those of you who posted your favorite scary movies, gosh, I'm tempted. I got to be careful what I say because this is the problem with being live. But I'm tempted for every single one of you comment, I'm going to mail you something. That's what I want to do. But we'll see how much the prints charge. Actually, you know, when we get them to a printer to get these out. But I want to get you guys a wrap in red poster. And I think that this is going to be just absolutely phenomenal. So let's talk. What are the other movies we got listed so far?
That's it.
So my friend Brandy comments on your art, and guys, yeah, any other questions, comments you want to throw out? Brandy says, all kinds of impressed with the ink, drawing, and pencil stresses me out. So the fact that you're, I guess, confident enough here to use...
Yeah, that's a good comment. I was like that too. I first started using pencil, and then, you know, once I saw ink, it's just so, so graphic. You know, there is no shade... Unless, of course, you add water and shade it, but it is either black or white. And that's a huge plus for this. But, you know, when it comes to being timid about it, it's a piece of paper in the end. There's nothing really to be too afraid of. And, you know, you just keep working with it until it looks good. And that's the beautiful thing about it.
So Brandy did my the first artwork I ever got for Rabbit in Red. She did as a surprise.
Oh,
and
awesome.
I got it somewhere. I actually think it might be... oh, yeah, I know where I've got it. So anyway, I'm going to pull that out. Yeah, it was fantastic. I absolutely loved it. I put it on my business card. So this is going to be really small, but the artwork that she has is much bigger. It's on a business card and a bookmark. But let me see if I can throw it up here so you can kind of see. So we've got a rabbit with its poor little paws chopped off. But I love it because it's bloody. And then there's the axe up in the corner. And then the full drawing, which I didn't get the full thing on here, you also get the little paper boat floating in the background. So who knows where that little paper boat comes from? What's the paper boat reference? You guys?
Let's find out.
Remember?
Let's read to find out.
You can't give away all those spoilers.
Yeah, it's
there
true.
Are people who haven't seen it.
It's true.
It.
You got to leave them something to hang on to, you know?
In other words, they don't know. That's basically what they're saying. well, and of course, Kaylee doesn't know because, like, she hasn't even seen Scream.
I haven't. I've seen it. Yeah, I've seen the one with...
Paperboat. You want me to spoil it for you?
I've seen 13 Ghosts with Monk. That was a good one.
All right. How it's a killer clown.
Oh.
Yeah, that's...
Isn't it the killer clown?
Very good.
Yay.
Pennywise, the dancing clown from Stephen King's It, is the, there's a little boat, so the boat is a nice reference to that. So yeah, keep throwing out comments, questions, anything. What I'd love to do is, for sure, any questions you have for Camron about art, definitely throw that out there. Any comments, that would be awesome. So Megan says, looking great, Cam, your talent always amazes me.
Oh, thank you.
Chuck says, I have to get back to math class, but that rabbit drawing rocks.
Hey, dude, go math. Get learning. You know, don't watch me start learning that math.
Thanks, Chuck, for joining us.
Thank you, Chuck.
Chad, and yeah, I've seen the new Omen. It was okay. The graveyard scene was great, but I love the old Damien movies, absolutely. I'm glad you guys are here and checking us out. So we're still going live. For those of you just tuning in again, we're doing a... live drawing inspired by the book Rabbit in Red. You can really see it coming together now. So
yeah.
Tell us a little bit more about your vision here. Because here's the cool thing, and this is one of my first positive impressions of you. I think that the day that you emailed me about this, I got an email from you like at 5:30 in the freaking morning.
Yeah.
Because you woke up excited with like a vision in your head.
Yeah.
Of course, I wasn't awake till like 2 hours later, but I just read the email like, wow, I like that. He's the first thing he's thinking about it. So
you know,
tell us about this
no
vision.
No fear in waking up early and sending some emails because, you know, you will read them when you read them. But yeah, I had an idea. Woke up and was just like, you know, my initial sketch design was cool, but I think this one's cooler. So right now we got the rabbit skull. Well, not a rabbit skull, but a human skull with rabbit ears to signify the rabbit in red in the story. And I'm wearing a virtual reality helmet here.
So you started with ink blots. Is that what you're?
Well, like I use an ink dropper.
Dropper.
And that gives me this like random line quality. It thickens and thins throughout, and that kind of just gives it this. It's kind of eerie look. And now, you know, the first level of shading is done. And then now I'm going to go with some ink and start detailing some things and darkening other areas here. And I can guarantee in probably the next 5 minutes, this thing will probably look different all over again. So
wonderful. So
yeah.
I'll pull away. We'll come back in about, I'll show you guys again in just a few minutes. All right. So again, comments, anybody, you know, if you want to throw out a favorite movie for us to chat about while we watch the artwork here come together, my goal is to get you guys a Rabbit in Red poster. So comment with a favorite film, favorite horror film, ideally, because that's a subject of the night. We're going to get you some posters. So Chad asks, any love for Signs? So Signs is the Mel Gibson one. You guys, have you seen this one?
Signs.
All right, Kaylee's got a movie she can talk about. Let's ask her. I'm just... All right. Oh, I'm sorry.
I've seen it a few times, actually. The first time I saw it was when I was younger. The second time was in my... Because I went to Notre Dame, which is a Catholic preparatory, for anyone who doesn't know. My religious teacher actually showed it in class.
Really?
Because Mel Gibson was a priest who comes back
to
his faith.
Who was this teacher?
You ask a lot of questions.
I went to Notre Dame, so I don't know if I may have had. The only one I remember is Mr. Irwin.
I love Mr. Irwin. I had him for
logic.
Oh my goodness, I cannot remember his name. It's not Mr. Brown's.
So I got a fun story. Oopsies. So to jump in while you're thinking. So Miss, are any of you guys watching the OJ made for TV thing that's live right now? But this is fantastic because if you watch this, it's so great because the Kardashian kids are absolute brats in the show, and they. Whoever's writing this movie is wanting to make fun of the Kardashians, I think. But one of the things that I like is you brought up watching this in your class, but I remember watching the trial I think it was Mr. Irwin's class. I don't want to like throw a shout out like that, but it was the verdict, so everybody was watching for sure. So anyway, yeah, Signs. What else about Signs?
It's a great, great movie. The shock factor in that, you know, it's such a slow burner.
Mm-hmm.
And then finally when you see these things, I mean, that's just terrifying. I think that those slow movies, the score, the original soundtrack is phenomenal. It terrifies me to this day, so.
I love the idea of fate, and so there's all these little subtle things. Like, I remember the little girl has, glasses of water everywhere, and Mel Gibson's character isn't he annoyed by it initially, but then they play a role at the end when, there's... No, we don't want to spoil the ending, but yeah, fantastic movie.
I think it did.
So we got some other comments jumping in here. We've got Wade who says, Cammy J is a beast. Question for the artist. Is it harder to draw knowing people are watching and ever drawn anything that gave him an eerie feeling? So is it harder to watch while people are watching and any eerie feeling?
No, so far it's really, I'm feeling pretty good about it. I'm not too nervous. Kind of in my element. This is my favorite style to work in, so... Doesn't really pose too much of a threat. Now, if you're wanting me to, you know, sit here and draw something extremely realistic, that's gonna cause me a little bit more stress. But no, so far this has been great.
Cool, wonderful. And anything? Have you drawn anything that's given you like nightmares or super eerie?
Oh goodness, no, no. I think all that happens before I start drawing. Honestly.
Yeah.
Get it all out right here on paper. But yeah, no. So. Can't scare the guy who's drawing the piece, so.
Cool. So let's check in and where you're at here. I'll give everybody a shot so that they can see it. And again, this is Rabbit in Red, the name of a Hollywood studio, and initially the contestants here go through a variety of virtual reality challenges, and then, of course, it evolves from there. But the idea was, let's take classic scenes. You know, one of the ideas they say if you're going to write a book, throwing out random advice, to write what you would always want to read or to fantasize about that which you would love to do. And not that I really want to be in a real horror movie where my life is actually in danger, but to be a part of that culture I think would be awesome. So that's part of it. It's like I would have loved contests like this where you're reenacting perhaps famous horror film scenes or changing them. And then, of course, our wizard behind the curtain mixes things up on everybody, and I'd like to think we had my own little twist here at the end. But this is the rabbit, and you can kind of see a skull face, right? And then you can see the virtual reality helmet, the headset coming into play. Very, very creepy, and I'm loving it. So, yeah, thank you for the comment there, Wade. We really appreciate it. Austin, you're fantastic as well.
What's
are great.
Up, Austin?
So, Austin, nice little comment on Facebook here.
Yeah, thanks,
and again,
Wade,
guys,
Austin,
I'm not ignoring YouTube either. If you got a comment you want to post on YouTube, you can certainly do that. I know YouTube's a little trickier because you have to log in or something first, so Facebook's nice to do the live comments. I'm sorry if I put my finger over the camera there.
Yeah, that's right. If you guys are wanting to see like an over-the-head shot, I think you guys do have to go on to YouTube.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so let me show you the YouTube link. If you do switch off for a second and want to check out the YouTube link. So on my page, on my Facebook page, I shared this link. But this is what it looks like on the shot. So we've got a nice little shot of the two of us. Hopefully you can see that okay.
I guess I should go on
the... Yeah, so there we go. That might look a little bit better. Sorry, guys, for my wonderful camera direction. But we've got, so you can see a nice close-up of the art as it's being drawn. I was way off, I know. But anyway, it's a good thing to check out if you happen to be, to switch back and forth and want to check out the YouTube link. That's pretty cool. And then we're chatting here. And I'm scrolling Camron's website. So definitely, you know, I appreciate him coming on tonight, and I absolutely doing this. So you want to check out some of his other artwork, CamronJohnson.com. You got a lot of art on there. So you've been doing this a long time.
I love putting stuff up there. You know, a lot of people will fear that. You know, what if somebody goes on there and takes it? Then they take it. There's nothing you can do about it. You know, it's if it's something you love to do, you got to get it out there, right?
Yeah, you got
to
show your work.
But yeah, visit the website. Let me know what you think. I mean, drop me a comment. Just tell me something about it, you know? It helps. It goes a long way. So, but yeah.
That's awesome.
Glad you're enjoying it.
For sure. So you went, did I read in your biography, is it Savannah?
I went to the Savannah College of Art and Design in Atlanta. Went there for a quarter before sending my portfolio to Illinois State University. That's where I continued the studio drawing degree there and got some help out there. And no, I loved it. Loved the path. Atlanta was great, but, you know, something just brings me right back here to the Midwest, so.
Yeah, absolutely.
Yeah.
For sure. All right, so, again, guys, anybody who wants to post a little comment, question, or just a favorite movie for us to discuss, we're talking horror films while Camron reimagines Rabbit in Red, and it is looking fantastic. I can't wait to see. It's just, I mean, we got to scroll over it again because the more ink that you put over it, it's popping.
It's shadows, you know? It's all about layers. That's what the ink, and, you know, people sometimes forget that you can re-wet it.
Right.
Pull it right back up. And then going over it in some pen and ink, yeah, it just makes things pop out. And then if I have time, I'm going to go back in with some white ink to make things really pop there in the middle. So.
Sure. Awesome. Yeah, absolutely. So we appreciate, again, you guys jumping and joining us. And what I want to do, my hope is a couple of things. Number one, to make some posters, some cool artwork, because, you know, I think that any successful project should have lots of different ways for people to kind of connect with it, and if this is what does it, that would be fantastic, you know. And I can certainly see, if I saw that on a book cover or on a poster, I'm pausing, I'm taking a look, I'm like, what is this?
That's the best
idea.
Thing about doing this, you know, is double takes.
Yeah,
I love people doing double takes because it shows that something is unique about something. You know, they're wanting another glance at it, they didn't understand it the first time around. But that's why I want to do book design. It's just a great way to put, you know, something that you love to do to work. So hoping that people will catch a book solely on their cover art, I think it's just a fun career.
Yeah, and definitely. So we got a couple, another comment here. Amber says, you are so talented. Your rabbit is looking awesome. So
what's Amber's last name?
Amber Johnson.
Oh, that's my wife.
I wonder.
Shout out to my wife.
Should have seen the name similarity there. Fantastic.
Hey, she's the best. So.
Absolutely.
She's the number one supporter. So.
Thank you for joining us and
you.
For watching. Absolutely. So tell us, book cover wise, do you have like some book covers out there that you think are really awesome? Like, is anything off the top of your head? Like, this is.
Oh, man, you know what got me going? When I was a little kid, and I used to love seeing this book come out of the show. It's called No David. And I don't know if any of you guys read that.
No,
if you've read
David.
It, let me know in the comments there. But Google it if you haven't. But you will understand why. It's like my style. That book basically describes how my childhood went.
Yeah.
And, no, that's it's a great book. That caught my eye right away.
That's awesome. That is fantastic. So yeah, I think cover art would be would be a great career. And believe it, you know, the more your name is out there, you're going to find there are a lot of I'm encountering writers all the time looking for help with that with design.
Would love to. You know, that's what I'm trying to
do. Are you on Twitter?
I have a Twitter, and that's the one I use the least. I use Instagram all the time.
Okay.
Instagram is great, but yeah, no, I need any sort of.
I think Twitter is probably a great way to connect with writers. You guys are tweeting about their work all the time. So, yeah, for sure. I'm going to get that out there. But, yeah, Instagram. So, Camron Johnson on Instagram. So, you post your artwork on there?
That's right. At Camron Johnson Illustrations. It's my Instagram feed. And I post a lot of sketch work on there. I keep it different than the website. You can still see the work on the website through the sketch tab. But a lot of my stuff on Instagram I will post daily or weekly. Just some random sketches that I do, whether I'm at, you know, at work and have a piece of paper and some time, or at home trying to figure out the ideas for my next piece.
That's awesome. So Camron Johnson Illustrations.
That's right.
And then on Instagram. So hopefully you guys will be able to check that out. Again, we got people popping in and out all the time. That's really cool. So for those of you, let me address the Facebook feed camera. So we've got a couple cameras set up here. This is my work office. Got a little, you know, All in the Reflexes sign. So I came up with the show title All in the Reflexes for a web show I wanted to do. And of course, do you guys know where All in the Reflexes comes from, what the line comes from?
I only do because you told us about it in class.
I told you about it before. It's All in the Reflexes. Jack Burton, ring a bell?
No. Why is this not ringing a bell for me?
It's an 80s movie,
right.
And it's, I'll give you a clue, it's supposedly being remade with The Rock as the main character. I'm not sure how I feel about it because this is one of my all-time favorite, like, 80s movies. You know?
I don't remember, quite honestly. I think, isn't it Burt Reynolds?
Not Burt Reynolds, but you know, it's Jack Burton's the name of the character played by Kurt Russell.
Oh.
In
How did I get Burt?
Big Trouble in Little China, right? And there's this fantastic scene, anyway, where they say that line a couple of times. One of my favorites is they throw, like, a knife at his head and then Jack Burton, the character, catches it and flings it right back, and it goes in the other guy's skull, and he's dead. It's beautiful. His line is, "It's all in the reflexes," and it's just like, yeah. Well, I love this kind of.
No, who's
Burt
Reynolds?
Stuff.
I don't even know where I got
Burt Reynolds
from.
Is a.
He's a character.
An older actor.
But it is someone that exists, so my brain just means, okay. I honestly thought I just made it up. Right?
So, you know, if we're doing a live, I thought it was a cool name because, number one, I love talking about movies and pop culture and things like that. So it's obviously a reference. But the other name, reason we call it All in the Reflexes, it's a live show. So we haven't talked about really anything we're talking about. Everything is just winging
like
it.
This happened.
It's beautiful. But anyway, I really do appreciate you guys tuning in and checking this out. And commenting or sharing. So a couple of plugs really quick. So anyway, the book that I wrote is Rabbit in Red. And let me tell you a couple of really cool things going on with it right now. Number one, I'm doing a book signing Saturday afternoon at Zeke's Comics and Games. That's in Washington in the Sunnyland Plaza, right where the Sunnyland Cinemas are. So Zeke's Comics and Games on Saturday, 12 to 4. I'd love for you to swing by. If you do and you happen to get the book, or even if you already have it and you're just shopping in the store, we're going to give away a little gift bag as a thank you. So come out Saturday afternoon, 12 to 4. I might turn on the live feature there just for a few minutes when we're at Zeke's, I think. So that might be really fun, but it's definitely a fantastic store. Lots of comic books, games, card games, board games, pop figurines, Funko Pop, all that type of stuff. Lots of really cool stuff. All right, so that's on Saturday. A couple other things. We're doing contests this week. One is with the best horror entertainment page out there, Fits of Horror, is running a contest, and all you have to do is go to the Fits of Horror page. So type that in Facebook or look at my page for any of those posts. Like, share, comment on that video, and you're entered to win some signed copies of this as well as those gift bags that way. And then if you're on Goodreads, if you're a reader and you got a Goodreads account, get to Goodreads, add the book to your account, and you're going to get entered into a Goodreads contest this month too. That's really cool. So that's what I've got going on. Some reintroductions. Again, for those of you just joining, this is an assistant here for our program and is an intern for our authors over at Distinguished Press. That's my publisher. She's actually going to be working with a few of our authors this semester. We set it up with, we have a new managing editor. She's actually the editor of Rabbit in Red. So shout out to Kathy Teal for your fantastic editing. And then you're working with a couple of our other authors, Charles is the author of The Newfoundland Vampire, Charles O'Keefe. So you're going to get to know his series. And C.J. Malarski wrote Ashwood, and you're going to get to know her series. Anyway, she's going to be doing a lot of work with us here, and that's really cool. But the purpose of our show, you know, we go the second and fourth Wednesdays of the month with a cool episode. But the purpose of our program tonight is to focus on this guy over here. This is Camron Johnson.
Hey, folks.
An artist, an alum of Illinois Central College, who also got a bachelor's degree in art.
That's right.
From Illinois State University. And so he is recreating, or I should say, you know, not necessarily recreating, it's the first one, but reimagining maybe what a cover for Rabbit in Red would look like, or doing some live artwork for us. So you can kind of see it there. Now it's really, really popping. That eyeball is awesome. So tell us a little bit more about what you're doing with...
Yeah, right now I'm getting some of the highlights. Just putting a little bit more highlights in to look at. Sometimes it's good to break up some of the shadows with either very stark blacks or very bright whites. So I'll probably just keep going through now and making things kind of pop out.
That's awesome. So definitely I see it. It's got, like, you know, again, I'm not an artist in this capacity, but it's got, I can already see, like, depth and dimension to it. You know, you can see, like, even looking at the ears, that's really cool. Like they almost have a 3D effect to them, right? It looks really cool. So anyway, I'm glad that you're here joining us. And if you want to leave a comment on our Facebook or YouTube page, we're going to try to get you. My hope is to get you guys some posters, because I really appreciate you joining the program and being supportive of one another, whether
yes.
you're a friend or you're just browsing Facebook and you're like, what is this thing going on? And you're clicking on and seeing it. So again, we got a live feed here on Facebook, but we're also live on YouTube. If you're on my page or Camron's or Kaylee's, you
yes.
should be able to see. The cool thing about the YouTube feature is that I've got a camera close-up directly on the art, and then you can still see us chatting in a box behind. And that's a cool feature. But the YouTube, the Facebook Live is a new thing here, too, that people can do on their pages. So we're definitely, I just covered you up with my hand. I'm sorry, but, you know, that's where we're live.
Hey, that happens. That's
I like the close-up of your cereal bowl. That we just got.
Well, it's a nice heart-healthy calendar in my office to remind me to eat for your heart's sake, I guess. So, it was just a free calendar. I just didn't want to pay for a calendar. That's really what it came down to. So, Kayla's excited about posters. Thank you. Kayla's going to be our guest next week. So next Wednesday, 6 p.m., same idea. You can subscribe to the YouTube channel, by the way. It's Joe Chianakas. So if you can spell my name, more power to you. But... would appreciate any time that you throw out some social media love. So you can find Camron on the web in a couple of places. He's got his website, CamronJohnson.com. So check that out for all of his artwork. And he's on Instagram, where he posts a lot more of his sketches and drawings.
That's right.
Camron Johnson Illustrations. And if you ever want to be come over to my office here and chat with me, I'd love to, you know, just let me know. So send me a message and tell me what you want to talk about, and we'll see if we can get it on the schedule. I've got a lot of exciting guests lined up, actually. We're pretty booked through the middle of April already with guests that have been who have contacted me for the show. So I'm really, I'm super excited about that. I won't give them all away yet. I guess one other plug, if you go to my website, which is joechianakas.com, or a better way to spell it, frightfest4d.com, which is having a little fun with the taking out of something from the book. So if you go to frightfest4d.com, there's a form where you can sign up for my newsletter. I send it out once a month and announce the guests for this program, so that you guys are the first to hear it. And then I announce everything else. So the Fits of Horror contest, the Goodreads contest, all those things were announced in the newsletter before I posted anywhere else. So if you want to follow along and be the first to know, that would be a great place to do it. So anyway, let's take a look again at the art here and see how it's going.
Yeah, it's getting a little depth in here now. Seeing what's going on.
So tell us why you do. Tell us about, you know, because I see you doing this a lot.
Yeah.
Talk to me about this technique. Like, I'm an art student, and
right,
I'm wondering what it is you're
sure.
doing. Tell me what's happening here.
Layering on this ink is helping things get pushed back into depth.
Okay.
So the brighter the highlight, the closer it's going to feel in three dimensionality. So if you need to push something back, you need to darken it and put it next to a high lighted surface.
Okay.
So that's, I believe it's chiaroscuro, that's light to dark. And that's a wonderful technique. A lot of people use that in pencil and charcoal, but I do it a lot in ink. It's it just creates depth and dimension and enables me to make something happen here on the paper.
That's awesome. That's awesome. So again, Camron Johnson, artist here, joining us to do some art for Rabbit in Red. And what we have going on here, especially for those of you who have just started watching, it's a human skull with rabbit ears, and you've got a virtual reality headset. So in the story, the characters do go through some virtual reality experiences, and they have to wear this. So the rabbit is a symbol in the story, not a character or anything like that. But this certainly pictures it, I think, just perfectly. So again, give us any questions or comments you have. Give us a little shout out. Let us know you're watching. And you want to talk to us about, so Drew's tuning in, Drew Anthony, and any comments or questions you might have about Camron's art, or we've been chatting about horror films a lot tonight too. What's your favorite movie? What's your favorite horror movie? Let us know that, and we'll take a look. We'll discuss that as well. So give us a little comment, and we'll be happy to chat with you about that. So tell me, what other projects are you working on right now, Camron?
Oh, like I said, I have a children's book coming along, a book of poetry that I'm hoping to eventually release here. I'm just still kind of working on the details and just different methods of getting it out there, but I have that going right now. And
what's the poetry about? Can I ask, like, what's like the theme of the poetry?
Yeah, absolutely. The theme of poetry, it's kind of complex. It's like more journalistic poetry, just ideas and thoughts that I have personally, you know, try to figure out with myself and quietly mostly, but figured out a way to get it out in words. And it's satirical, but it's pretty funny. Some of the stuff that you're going to read, it brings up good points in the world, whether it's like religion or politics, but I try not to get too deep into that. But there's some hit and miss opportunities to poke some fun at a few things. But
sure.
As far as other things going, I have a showing coming up. In March at Behind the Glass Gallery, that's located in downtown Bloomington. Natalie Roseman, she's great. She helped me set up a nice place, and she runs the gallery there. She does a great job. And so hopefully that show goes well, and that's starting up in March. And then I'll be doing another live demo there actually on the 19th of March. So
awesome.
It's in downtown Bloomington. Shoot me an email if you have any questions about that. But yeah, that should be great.
Yeah, so you can get his email and contact info on his website, CamronJohnson.com. And Camron is spelled CamrOn.
That's right.
Johnson.
Cut.
Yeah,
oh.
So.
What's up with that, right?
I don't know.
Oh.
So yeah, appreciate you being out here. So what are you going to live draw down in for your exhibit there?
Oh, that's going to be a little special piece relating to the book of poetry. So I'm not going to throw that out there quite yet, but you have to come out and see.
All right. Wonderful, wonderful. So I was wondering what Kaylee's noises were over here, and evidently she spelled your name wrong. But,
I did.
That's all right. I love
sorry.
It. So, Zach, another great movie is Fear.com. Fear.com. You guys know Fear.com?
I don't.
I'm not sure. I'm not sure. I know I've seen it, Zach.
That happens. Trust me. It happens.
I know I've seen it. It's just I like, because the most recent kind of internet web-based one I saw was Unfriended. It was
okay.
Just so, I don't know if it's kind of similar to Unfriended, maybe. I'm not sure, but it had, because it was one of those where people are streaming live and talking about their program, and and they're getting like axed one at a time, even though they're like live chatting via Skype with one another.
Happens.
Yeah, you know, and just be careful how much time you spend online, right? So
that's right.
I love
it. It's a really supervisor.
I think it's really cool have you heard YouTube's making like a Netflix type thing for itself? Maybe you'll get picked up for that.
YouTube Red.
I'm a big YouTube fan. I love Rooster Teeth, which is a gaming one actually. And
that's awesome.
They just made a whole movie that was completely like crowdfunded and everything.
Really?
A whole movie called Laser Team. Just did a special release. That was pretty cool. Maybe you'll get to be able to do that.
You never know whether it's one follower or 100. You know, you start somewhere. And so, yeah, if you guys are on there and you want to subscribe or share the YouTube link, that'd be fantastic. And I don't know. I think with things like this, Facebook's going to give YouTube a little bit of a run for its money. And I think until you build a big YouTube following, Facebook's going to be the way to get it. Because the neat thing about it is when you go live on Facebook, it alerts. It tells everyone. And you go to the top of your page, and it's
right.
Kind of interesting. So where are we at here with your work?
Oh, we're getting close. getting close to a finishing point here, I think. Tried to keep it under an hour. Might go over a little bit, but that's okay. But
yeah, that's cool.
Yeah, we're finishing up here. Just a few more pushes of black ink here, India ink, and we'll see where we're at here. I kind of want to make this go further back than this pair of goggles. So to do that, you would take a little bit of black ink, push it along the side there.
We're so quiet. Just so
I know, we're watching.
It's peaceful.
So
it's peaceful.
It is nice.
Super therapeutic. That's another huge reason I do this, honestly, is that it gives me something other than, you know, something else to do, to just kind of quiet myself and let my hand do the talking sometimes.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah, so those of you guys, again, we got a few who've hopped on rather recently. So you can see this is from Rabbit in Red. This is going to be a, at least initially, the way that I envision using it as a promotional art and poster. And who knows, down the road, I want to be careful what I say because it's not just my decision. And we've got a couple other people who would love to do a cover that are out there too. But I would love to obviously just get the coolest vision out there, maybe for book two. So who knows, you could potentially be seeing either a new cover for book one, or who knows, a cover for book two or even three down the road. What I like about this is that in the story, I want the rabbit to be creepy. You know, I mean, it's meant to be a symbol of this Hollywood horror production studio, but it's not necessarily meant to be a cute, cuddly thing that you would hold in your hands. It's meant to be a little creepy. At the same time, this also encompasses the virtual reality component. And I think that we're seeing more and more of virtual reality in pop culture, not just with things like Oculus Rift, but on the front page, I believe, of the New York Times just today, there was an article that talked about how science and technology industries are actually turning to science fiction works to get ideas. And so you would think, you know, it's really interesting to see how that, you know, it makes sense in my mind, but, you know, you would think, if you're a scientist, are you picking up a sci-fi book for ideas? I guess so. And so that's really cool, and I like this idea. And so I don't want to give away, obviously, too much of book one either for those who haven't read it. But book two, obviously no one, just a couple of people out there have read book two. But we take virtual reality in a whole new way. And I tell you, my goal with book one was to make it fun. Like, if you're a horror lover, you're going to get excited and be like, oh my God, I want to do this, until things get a little twisted and scary. And book two, I want you to crap your pants. And so as I'm working on these scenes, I'm figuring out what is the most terrifying thing I can do. And, you know, yeah, I mean, I have a scene where it's too much on someone and he almost dies. And I think that's awesome. So a little sadistic perhaps, but wonderful at the same time. So, all right, so we got some other comments on there. Let's take a look. So Kayla says, I absolutely adore his art. Very talented and unique. As for favorite horror film, it's very hard to choose, but all of the Halloweens are classics, and VHS
nice.
Kind of messed me up. I liked, yeah, I've seen two of the VHS. I don't know if I've seen them all, but I liked VHS a lot too. Have you guys seen VHS?
Yeah, I have.
Yeah.
It's pretty wonky. It'll get you. It's got a lot of, like, pop-up scares.
Yeah.
I can't do the pop-up. Like, I'm really afraid of thunderstorms. I hate thunderstorms. Because it just pops up, and I'm not expecting it, and then I get scared. Like, honest to God, I hate thunderstorms.
Sure. Well.
Those are my fears.
I love a good thunderstorm.
I as well,
you
know.
Yeah.
And there's nothing like laying in bed and just hearing the rain.
Oh,
yeah.
The roof. Oh, man.
Zach says the overall plot, I guess this was for Fear.com, was kind of like The Ring, but it was done in a hide-and-seek kind of way with some little girl's ghost.
Mm.
I like characters where the children, or stories where the children are kind of creepy, too. Do you guys, what's your favorite, like, creepy child character? Do you have can you think of a creepy child?
Oh, wow. The Babadook. It's a new movie on Netflix.
I love that one.
Great movie. Interestingly, like half and half feedback, but wow.
Netflix.
Watch it.
Yes, get it on. That was a great one. I don't know. Babadook.
Yeah,
I remember that being very creepy, very cool. Give me another childhood one. So this is a little older, but Gage from Pet Sematary. I look at Kayla and ask her if she's seen it.
Nice.
I'm going to have to look at Cameron and say,
yeah, no,
Pet Sematary.
Yeah, he, first one, right?
Yeah.
He was, pretty much picked off by that semi truck.
Yeah.
And then he came back through the pet cemetery, right?
Yeah, it's super creepy.
Yeah.
He's creepy even before he's dead,
yeah.
as far as I'm concerned. Like, just looking in his eyes, I'm like, that were my child, I might throw him in front of the cemetery. I'm just kidding. That's terrible. I'm so sorry.
Oh, my. Well, you know, if he's a strange little evil demon brought back from the pet cemetery, that's...
So I'm pulling up a close-up here, too. Tell us what you're doing now.
Oh, just adding a little more detail. It's all about the detail now, you know? Just adding in more things for the eye to see. It's important to have little moments all throughout the piece that somebody can notice. It's a good time.
Yeah, this looks fantastic. So this is the type, I mean, we do posters of this, and I send them out to you guys who are commenting. This is the type of poster you'd want in your bedroom, right? Like right above your
yeah,
head.
Yeah, right
that
above
one
your
big eye popping
over
in the middle of the night.
Closet, you know?
I would love it. And if you guys would do that, and I get you those posters, and you put them on there, that'd be fantastic. Are you yaying because I was back on you?
Yeah, you like had enough focus on me, so just kind of... I can tell you the most annoying kid in a horror movie.
Okay, most annoying.
In The Purge, which I got through like half of.
Oh, love The Purge.
I hate that movie because that little kid lets in the guy.
Well, the kid is stupid.
But the parents don't yell at him. If that was my kid, I'd push him off the roof.
I
like,
do
I
often
would,
hate the children.
I hate that kid. I couldn't finish that movie. Dang. So I was so angry about the parenting in that movie.
Now,
I couldn't finish
here's a good horror movie discussion. Name a sequel that is better than the original. And I'll start with The Purge, because actually The Purge Anarchy is better than the first Purge. So you got to watch the second
one.
Because there's a third one coming out 4th of July weekend,
that
Purge Election.
That kid ruined it for me.
I like
what are his parents doing? Yeah.
I like the second one, too. I thought it was better than the first one.
Yeah, exactly.
The first one I actually didn't like until after I saw it.
A second time. Same here.
First
exactly.
time I saw it, not
exactly.
I was just kind of like...
I remember seeing the trailer for The Purge and making everyone watch it because I'm like, oh my gosh, this looks fantastic. And then going to see the movie and feeling a little disappointed, let down, to think maybe, you know, too excited. But I think my problem with The Purge is, didn't you feel like, and I've heard other people say this, it's almost like you feel claustrophobic, like you're stuck in that house the whole time. And when Purge Anarchy comes out, you're outside the whole time and there's a lot more that goes on. But yeah, I rewatched the first Purge before the second and thought, oh wait, this is actually pretty good. I don't know what I was thinking, but I think...
It hit in the right spot sometimes,
yeah.
But no, I think the second one was a little bit better.
Second one definitely better. So, for sure, any other sequels out there that you think are better than the original? So, Zach, I'm surprised nobody has mentioned the Goosebumps TV show movies. Goosebumps! Oh, we could talk about it. Have you guys seen the Goosebumps movie?
Not the new one, no. I was about to rent it the other day, but got something else instead, but I will pick that one up.
Yeah,
so
that was a lot.
Jack Black, I'm a big fan of Jack Black. Ever since School Rock... It's like a great movie.
I enjoyed the Goosebumps movie. It was perfect. You know, it was fun. It was silly. It was
okay.
Good characters at the same time. But yeah, I don't know. My reading career, like what influenced me as a writer, I think the most, and as a reader, is I grew up on R.L. Stein, but I grew up on the R.L. Stein that existed before he started Goosebumps, really. So I mean, I definitely read some Goosebumps, but I read you guys remember the Fear Street ones? Like, there used to be the Fear Street books, and I don't know. He had a bunch of ones like that. And then Goosebumps came out, which is for slightly younger audiences. And I think it's almost like I was a couple years too old, but I still read a bunch of them. And so, yeah, I grew up on probably junior high Joe read a lot of R.L. Stein and Christopher Pike. And then when I got into high school, I finally picked up Stephen King. And then, you know, I stopped reading the others because... This was massively adults and sick and disgusting and disturbing, and I couldn't stop.
Kept you reading.
Right? Yeah, absolutely kept you going, so for sure. So Drew says, School of Rock, one of the best of all time. I definitely love School of Rock. So Donna says to ask you about The Descent.
The Descent.
That
is a great movie as well. That movie, I'm pretty much 100% sure it gave me a panic attack in the theater. I specifically remember... being shocked so bad that it's like having like little heart flutters there. But gosh, that's a great movie if you haven't seen it. Have you seen it?
So tell me. No, I don't
know. It's about a group of ladies, very adventurous ladies going, and they're spelunky. And they decide to go in a cave dive down a cave. And I'm not quite sure. I can't remember where. But I'll just say things don't go as according to plan.
Really?
Yeah, it's a great movie. You definitely got to check that out if you're a horror fan.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like it sounds familiar. I'm not really sure if I've seen it or not. So Well, we're into our second hour here, guys. This is awesome. So we've been going here an hour and 13 minutes, and I'm live here with artist Camron Johnson, who's doing a drawing here of Rabbit in Red. This is a program that I'm hosting twice a month normally, and it's a program I called All in the Reflexes, just like a little talk show to get to talk with ICC students and the really cool things that they're doing. Cameron's an ICC grad who is now into art and hopes to make a complete living in life out of book illustrations, and he's doing it. He's publishing all sorts of great things that are out there, and you can learn more at CameronJohnson.com. So what we're looking at here is a drawing for Rabbit in Red, which is my horror novel, the first in the trilogy. So are you at a stopping point here? Or?
Yeah, you know, I think if things are ready to be wrapped up, not much can be added except for a little background effect, but I think that can be added later on, but I think here's a good...
So, yeah, it looks wonderful. If you're watching live on the YouTube link, it looks perfect. But let's hold up for this one.
Yeah. Absolutely.
See if we can't get it perfectly in there and adjust.
Waiting for it to...
Yeah. So, does that look good on the camera? Yeah.
It does.
So let's...
It's pretty good.
That is awesome. So that you can really, from this angle, and just direct me a little bit.
Let's pull this here like that. Perfect.
Yeah.
There you go. If you want to get a little closer in there.
This looks
wonderful.
Great YouTube.
So if you're watching YouTube, we're like, oh, we're all over the place. It's wonderful. but look at the detail, guys. I mean, it's, gosh, I don't know, like cracked bone almost in there. And you can see the outlines of the teeth. The nose is phenomenal. I love that nose. That is creepy. And the eye, like I said, I'm going to get you guys this poster. And wow, you know, that this would be absolutely fantastic. You can see the virtual reality headset is broken, so imagine it getting smashed. And what in the story might actually make that happen? That's a cool thing to kind of think about. But you get the rabbit theme, you get the virtual reality theme, and you certainly have a horror theme in there, don't you? Absolutely. So I guess we're at a wrapping up point. You guys have been watching. Some of you guys have been watching for a long time. Others of you I know just jumping in.
Thanks for staying tuned, guys.
This has been awesome. So again, I'm Joe Chianakas, author of Rabbit in Red and professor at Illinois Central College. This is Kaylee Christian. She's a student here at ICC as well, who's got a huge amount of dreams and whatnot on your list, too. We're going to chat more about those in one of our episodes for sure. But she's going to help us out. She's making sure that everything's lined up here. But over our star tonight, Mr. Camron Johnson,
hey,
artist, book illustrator. So again, you can go to CamronJohnson.com to learn more about him. You can follow him on Instagram at Camron Johnson Illustrations. And so tell us one more time about the book show coming up, or your art show.
Absolutely. Over at Behind the Glass Fine Art Gallery, that's in downtown Bloomington. I'll be having a show in March. It'll be up March 1st through the 31st. And then on the 19th, I'll be doing another live demo. That one's going to last a little longer. I'll probably be there around 4 hours or so on a little bigger piece. And finishing up some work there. So that's Behind the Glass Studios. I'm sorry, Behind the Glass Fine Art Gallery. Natalie Roseman, she's great, setting that up, and I'll be up there March 1st through the 31st.
That is awesome. As for me, I'll be at Zeke's Comics and Games in Sunnyland Plaza, that's in Washington, Illinois, this Saturday from 12 to 4. You want to get a copy and get it signed, come see me at Zeke's. And then online, we're doing some other contests. Just follow my Facebook page for that, whether we're friends or you're on my author page, which is facebook.com/Chianakas. You give that a like, you'll see I've shared a page called Fits of Horror. I hope you like that one out too. We're doing an awesome contest on there. We're going to give away a bunch of stuff. And then if you're on Goodreads, make sure you add the book on Goodreads, and there's a contest there too. What I want to do, and again, this is a live show, so I'm kind of speaking off the top of my head, but my hope is to get every single one of you who commented on our feed today. Up to this point, I'm going to get these made into posters for promotional art for Rabbit in Red, and I'm going to get you each a copy. So if you've made a Facebook comment, send me a Facebook message with your address. I promise I won't stalk you, even though I write about things like that. So if you don't trust me, then I don't know. That is a little tricky. But send me your address. I'm going to keep a list of that. We're going to get some posters made, and we've got some other ideas. We're going to do some color art in the background maybe, and some other things going on here. But we wanted to show you the original. So one more time, let's take a look at the drawing here. Just one more time. How is it?
Yeah.
We're going to end really shaky. There it is.
There
that's perfect. So I really appreciate coming out, Camron, and I really appreciate all of you guys who've been watching the show. FrightFest4D.com is my website, and I'll certainly post more information on there. So lots of stuff for you to check out. Thanks for following along. That's it.
Okay,
good night.
Bye. Bye. Still going.
So bye.
Bye, YouTube.
Adios.